Hello, I'm Daphne Dennis and I'd like to give you a brief overview of my article, Management of Mycosis Fungoides, Focus on Chlormethine Gel.
Mycosis fungoid, let's say MF, is the most frequent cutaneous T-cell lymphoma. However, it remains rare, and randomized studies are lacking to determine the best treatment for this disease. It is defined histologically, and the clinical usual presentation consists of patches or plaques in sun-protected areas. One very important point when diagnosis is made is to stage the disease according to the ISCL EURTC classification. Indeed, the prognosis is very different between early and advanced stage disease. In 2017, the European Organization for Research and Treatment of Cancer published therapeutic guidelines. In this review, we try to summarize them by disease stage to help clinicians in their daily practice. Basically, early stage MF requires skin-directed therapies, whereas in advanced stage MF, these therapies are combined with more aggressive general therapies. New targeted therapies are emerging in these forms. A topical chemotherapy with chlormethine has been used in MF for more than 50 years. It works as an alkylating agent by affecting rapidly dividing cells and by enhancing the host potential. As it's a skin-directed treatment, it's indicated in early-stage disease. Before the 80s, nitrogen mustard was prepared in water with the disadvantages of being unstable and often causing hypersensitivity reactions. In the 80s, an ointment preparation was introduced with a decreased risk of sensitivation, decreased cost, ease of application, and an emollient effect. However, this form was not used everywhere because of the absence of guarantee on stability. What's new is the gel form, approved by the FDA in 2013 and the EMA in 2017. It was approved following a study conducted by Lessin et al., showing an overall response rate of 58%. It showed a slight decrease in efficacy, but no concomitant treatment was permitted. The main adverse event remains allergic contact dermatitis, which seem lower when this treatment is associated with dermocorticoids.
To conclude, the skin-directed treatment is practical as it allows treatment of outpatients and the association with dermocorticoids seems safe and effective. Thank you.